polygon with with 200 sides. Okay, polygon with 200 sides. Then some two diagonals of this polygon subtends an angle less than 1 degree. Okay? Now, what do you mean by that? Suppose I have two lines, then two lines make two angles. Okay, this is one angle and this is 180 minus that angle. Correct? This angle will be recurved, this is again 180 minus theta. One of these two angles will be less than 1 degree. And what do you mean by diagonal of a polygon? It is defined as a segment joining two adjacent which are non-adjacent. Correct?
Yes, miss.
What is your name? I can't see your face.
Krish.
Krish, Krish. Can you see this polygon with 200 sides? Prove that.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. We are trying to prove this. He is to a certain extent very correct. That if all my diagonals would have been passing through a single point, if they would have been congruent. Forget about all diagonals. Because we have 200 sides, we can take, suppose I label the vertices as A1, A2, A200. Then you can take A1, A100, this major diagonals, even if I consider A2, A101. Okay? Joining after 100. Correct? See, for example, I'll give you an example of hexagon. Suppose this is a hexagon. Okay? A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6. Okay? Now, you have different types of diagonals. Okay? See, this is one diagonal. Okay? But the major diagonal is this one. Here for hexagon, n is 6. So 1 plus 3, A4. Correct? This is the major diagonals. Correct? Followed? Huh? So even if you take major diagonals, A1, A101, A2, A102, so on till A 100, A200. Even if these 100 diagonals you take, then also you can easily clear it. Followed? Provided they are passing through a single point. Then we have 100 lines passing through a single point, so they will make all 200 angles indefinitely. Then can we say sufficient? No. How many angles we need?
More than
360 angles. So only these diagonals are not sufficient and they are not passing through a single point. Okay, but how many diagonals do we have for an n-sided polygon? 198 diagonals.
N into n minus 3 by 2.
Yes, why? Because if you consider a vertex V, to draw a diagonal, it cannot be connected to itself. Neither it can be connected to these. Correct? So it will be connected to n minus 3 other vertices. Can you see that? So number of diagonals is equal to n into n minus 3. But if I take a diagonal, say AB, by this procedure I am counting it, when I am counting A, diagonals through A as well as diagonals through B. So I need to divide by it. Correct? So total number of diagonals will be how many? N into N minus 3 by 2. Now same thing I can prove by some other method. Okay? Now to find diagonals, what I will do is I choose total number of segments. What is total number of segments? That will be n into n minus 1 by 2. First segment can be chosen in n ways, second can be chosen in n minus 1 ways. Correct? Followed? And A and B can be interchanged. Or those who know combinatorics, it is NC2. Out of which n are sides? So total number of diagonals will be what? N into n minus 1 by 2 minus n sides. So that will become correct. So I have 200 sides, then how many diagonals? So total number of diagonals of 200 sides will be 200 into 197 by 2 or 1970. We have sufficiently large number of diagonals. Correct? Correct? is parallel to D2 and so on. Okay? Draw lines through a single point that are parallel to diagonals. Am I clear to everybody? What will happen if I am taking parallel lines? Will the angle between diagonals change? Angle between diagonal D1, D2 will be same as angle between L1, L2. And all these lines will pass through a single point P. That means what? There will be 19,700 lines. So into two angles, obviously some two lines will make, any of them will make angle less than 180. Alright? Now tell me the minimum number n such that this angle is less, guaranteedly less than 180. With n sides, if I take n side, what should be the minimum n? That this angle is guaranteedly less than 180. So in mathematics, this is very important. Create what you want. Okay? You don't have a segment passing through a point, create segments passing through a point. With what property I need to prove? I need to prove angles to keep angles same. Is that clear to everybody? Now many of the students are asking me, how many of you are in 8th standard? So they were asking me all Prabhutva doubts. So you can ask Prabhutva doubts. If you are in 8th standard, please WhatsApp me and get yourself added to the Prabhutva group. And add your friends also to Prabhutva group. N into 2n minus 3 is greater than 367. So now we want polygon with n sides. And such that some two diagonals of this polygon subtend angle less than 1 degree, find smallest such n. Okay? For n, number of diagonals is this. So what will be number of possible angles?
29.
Yes, correct. Will be n into n minus 3. And this should be greater than 360. So smallest such n is 29, correct. Now, I think last time we have done similarities in right angle triangles. Triangle properties, few properties of quadrilaterals. We have done all that. Okay, now it's a time to go to the circle. on this. The most important figure in Olympiad geometry is the circle. Can we define the circle? How do we define a circle?
Okay.
major arc AB is 2 theta and P is any point on the opposite arc, okay, then major angle APB must be equal to theta.
Major arc
or major and minor character. Okay. Now here, if O is on the segment, one of the segment of the angle, and then we know that measure of this angle or measure of this arc is twice of this angle, correct? Therefore, what can we say? What can we say about major angle? BOQ. BOQ will be equal to
2y.
Correct? And major angle AOQ will be 2 times x plus y. Correct? So what can you say about angle AOB?
2x.
That is twice of angle AB. Correct? Easy? This is one of the most important theorem. Okay? Hold on. Many people doesn't know its application nicely. They can't solve many good problems. Excursion.
My first part two.
Very good. Which angle we know here? This is this is exterior angle of this triangle. So what it will be? N plus N. Right? Can you see that? Here, let me join this in. What can you say about this angle? Tell me what this angle will be.
N.
N. Because it will be half of this arc to N. Correct? And what can you say about this arc?
N.
M. Now in this triangle, this is exterior angle. So suppose this is theta, then what you will get? M is equal to N plus theta. So what is theta?
M minus.
Correct? angle between the tangent and secant is equal to half of the arc subtended by that secant angle. Here also we have cases. Case 1 is PQ passes through center, or angle, better I write in this way, angle QPT is equal to 90 degrees. So that means passing through center, correct?
Thank you.
And measure of this arc is how much? 2 feet. Correct? So what can you say about measure of this arc? What can you say about measure of this arc?
360 minus 2 theta.
So 360 minus 2 theta. Correct? Which kind of angle is this?
Acute.
Because this is obtuse, so this has to be acute. Correct? So for acute angle we have already proved the theorem. Correct? That means what will be this angle?
180
minus theta. Correct? So this has to be maybe if we join these. Suppose this is point Q and P and Q. Prove that quadrilateral PQCD is cyclic. So ask for BC link and So if you have a cyclic quadrilateral, sum of the opposite angles is 180 degrees. Now try to prove this. M is a midpoint of RKB and it MC and MD cut quad AB and PLQ, then prove that this is cyclic. Now this was very easy. You already know what is measures of these angles. We have done in the theorem. Correct? So you just substitute and you will get it. How many of you want this? You have not tried. Try, you know what is we have done in the theorem. Try, do it. Do it right.
BPD.
Your friend is not coming. There is one more boy with you who needs to come.
Yes.
Where is he?
He's doing 10 exams.
Oh, he's in 10. There was one of my students, Parth Kothari. He cleared RMO consecutive 4 years. 4 times. 9, 10th, 11th. That time 12th was 11th. He used to come just like few days before 10th board also for a high level college. Still he scored good in board. Swayam was also in. Swayam is also in. Yes, done. See how easy it is. I need to find out some pair of opposite angles. Okay? So, try to find one pair of opposite angles and then show they are supplementary.
Thank you.
Okay. Which all? Who all doesn't have this domain? The other center you don't have?
Mom.
Huh? Jalgaon center?
No, ma'am.
Mom, Jalgaon center has not got this booklet.
Not got this booklet? You asked for the booklet, huh? Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, left part proved.
Left part proved? Very good. Let us discuss left part. See, I have taken this argument as 2x, 2y, 2z, 2w. So, first thing is, I should write x plus y plus, what is that? Correct? Easy? See, these are all tiny tiny things which will help you in your problem solvings for Olympia.
Thank you. Ma'am?
Yes.
I am getting PDOA is a kite. Will that help?
PDOA. E What is 180 minus 1? APR is
180 minus 2 bar.
So
EPA is 1.
EPA is 1. Exterior angle of cyclic quadrilateral is
equal to the opposite interior angle.
Correct. If you have this angle y, then this angle will be y in cyclic quadrilateral. So what can you say about this is cyclic quadrilateral, right?
Yes.
So this angle is y, so this angle will be y. And this is x, so this is x. Interior equals up the angle greater than this angle beta. theta, angle in the exterior will be smaller. Okay? What I am going to do this, do it here is, suppose this is the cluster of my some 2003 points. Okay? What I will do is, I will take some line segment containing some two points here such that rest all points are on same side. How can I achieve this? Take a line and keep shifting it till it meet first point. Okay? Suppose it meet the point A. Okay? Then slowly tilt it, tilt it, tilt it, till it meet the very first point. Call it B. Okay? I'll repeat. What I did, I took a line which is not passing through any of these points, which is on the, all the points are on the same side. That can be done. Shift it, shift it, shift it. Parallel to itself till it first meet any of these points. Call that point A. Then if it is passing through the second point, well done. If it is not, then shift, slightly rotate that. Okay? Till it pass to very first point, which is B. So rest all 2001 points are on same side. Correct? So this is my line AB. And what I have is, I have 2001 points on the same side. So let us call this point P1, P2 up to P2001. And call the angles A, P, I, B as theta. Okay? Now, so A, P1B is theta 1, A, P2B is theta 2 and so. Can I have A, P1B is equal to or A, XB is equal to A, PYB?
No.
Why not?
Because they are not common.
Yes, because then the points will become coincident. If I have any two angles equal, then the points will become coincident. This is not possible. Why? Because then AB, PX and PY are coincident. Correct? Now they are not coinciding. So we don't have any two thetas equal. What we will do is, we will arrange this thetas. Suppose I relabel the thetas such that they are in increasing order. Okay? Okay, relabel thetas. Okay? Such that theta 1 is smaller, and of course I can do that, correct? And accordingly I will relabel the corresponding points also. Now, this angle is my theta 1001. My theta 1, theta 2, theta 1001 are all less than this. Means what? What is the conclusion? All points will be
outside.
Angles which are less than it will lie outside. So my P1, P2 till P1000 will lie outside. Correct? And all these angles.
Can you repeat again?
Yes. See, if my angle is on this circle, if APB is less than beta, the point will lie outside. And if it is greater than beta, the point will lie inside. Correct? In this figure? Everybody understood that? So same way here, theta 1, theta 2 till theta 1000 are less than this angle. A, P1B, P1001B, correct? So all angles which are less than that, all point that subtends angle less than this will lie outside. Correct? And all the points which subtend angle greater than it will lie inside. So all the points P1002, P1003 till P2001 will lie inside. So we have three points on the circle A, B, P1001, 1000 points outside the circle and 1000 points inside. Can you see that? Is it clear to everybody? Any doubt anybody? Very. Now.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Is it 5 upon 8 A plus B or A minus B? Not
A plus B. Achha, it is not clear. It is a rectangle. Quadrilateral ABCD is a rectangle with sides A and B. This is the RMO problem. RMO 1993. Should I explain once again? See, this is R1 and and this is R1. So OBC is isosceles. This is the perpendicular. So this should be the midpoint, right? Perpendicular of isosceles, perpendicular of isosceles triangle, bisect the base.
Yes.
So this is A1, this is A. A1 by 2, A1 by 2. This is the radius, so this will be the radius, so this is B minus R1, correct?
Ma'am.
Yes.
I got R1 as A square plus 4B square upon 8B.
A square
plus 4B square upon 8B.
8B. Okay, yes, correct.
Thank you.
is AQ plus BQ. I can factorize it.
AQ square minus AB plus B square.
Correct? Now since A and B are lengths, so A plus B is not zero, obviously. So I can cancel it from both sides. So it is equivalent in showing or if you shift AB here,
A minus B the whole square.
A minus B the whole square is greater than C. Is it true?
Yes.
Always. We know any real square is always
possible.
Or easy method is those who know A and GM inequality. What is A and GM inequality? For any two positive reals, x plus y is greater equal to root x1. Correct? So I'll apply AMGM on this. Let me apply AMGM here. So what I will get? A square by b plus b square by a is greater than 2 under root a square upon b into b square upon a. What is this? Root a. Correct? Okay? Those who are new, so I will do all the theory. Those who know the theory, They It will have only direct common tangents and no transverse common tangents. Correct? Can you see that? So number of tangents will be 2. And what you can say is the relation of distance d will be, what is relation of distance? D will be less than R1 plus R2. Correct? Now fourth case is that once they are internally tangent. So you have, this is your O2 and this is your O1, and you will have only
one
common tangent, correct? And suppose point T, then again you have O2, O1 and T are collinear, because both of them will form 90 degree with this tangent, correct? Both the radii are perpendicular to this tangent, so they are bound to be collinear, correct? In this case, what will be distance D?
R2 minus R1.
Yes, D will be R2 minus R1. So that is why here we'll get that this D is greater than R2 minus R1 and less than R1 plus R1. Okay? Fifth is, if D is less than R2 minus R1, in this case, number of tangents, no. Sorry, in this case number of tangents was 1. In
zero.
This case,
zero.
The special
zero.
Case here will be concentric circle when T is equal to
0.
Alright. These are the tangent segments. And they meet at point P. Or they meet at point O. And suppose P and Q are the centers of the circles. Okay? So what I have is P and Q are centers of the circle. With radii. R1 and R2. And AC and BD are common tangents. Their point of intersection is O. Then, firstly, P dash Q dash O. Second, AO upon, sorry, CO upon AO is equal to
DO
upon BO is equal to QO upon PO is equal to R1 by R1. Okay?
Thank you.
1 lakh. Now we'll prove it.
Second one will be PAO, diamond PAO is similar to QCO.
PAO similar to QCO.
From that.
Yeah, similar. But first one? First you have to prove first one. To use second. To prove second. First one is also not that difficult. Yes, done. First one is done. Can I run this? No. For first one, consider triangle. Which is very old name, that's why. This is called external center of similitude and this is simply length of tangents? No. Sorry?
The thing which you wrote just now, the internal center of vicinity. I was drawing it.
You were?
Can you draw it again?
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Thank you.
will be equal to R1 plus R2. Distance between centers will be R1 plus R2. So this will become under root R1 plus R2 square minus, and we know how much is this, A plus B whole square and same as
4AB.
So this is 2 root R1. Let us see two beautiful applications of this. First application. Suppose these are two circles with center A and B tangent to each other and radii are small a, small b, and L be the common tangent. Am I going too fast? For students who are doing this for first time, am I going too fast? Okay. So we have two circles A with centers A and B and radius small a, small b, and a direct common tangent L. And we have one more circle here touching all three with center C and radius small c. And we have to prove that 1 upon root C is equal to 1 by root A plus 1 by root B. Now, this is direct application of this problem.
Yes, we can take two circles at a time.
Very good. Because in this information we have only two circles at a time. Correct? So what you should do? We should first take point of contact. Okay? Suppose point of contacts are P, Q, R. Then we know distance PR, we know QR, we know PQ. We can encash that. You will definitely try this. This is very easy. Once you know this, this is very, very easy. This was in more first year when you know awkward. I don't remember the year. I think 59 or 60. I don't remember. First in more paper. Last problem was this. Okay? But that time this property was not popular. Okay? Now, second application of this very property is, suppose we have direct common tangents, and we have three circles in a row. With centers A, B, C and radii also, small a, small b, small c. Prove that AC is equal to B square.
Second
is proved with this one.
Yes.
Second is proved. Very good.
Ma'am, first one proved.
Very good. This is wrong because A and C are not tangent circles, are they? See, okay. Many of you are doing that mistake. Okay. See, this formula is applicable only if they are tangent circles. Otherwise, you have to use this formula for A and C. No?
A. Ma'am, for this one, B. B would be A plus B plus C, right?
A plus 2B plus C.
Yes.
See, this formula is applicable only for tangent circles. So this formula is applicable for TA and TBC. Correct? Not for A and C. Okay? So let me give you this.
Which part? Because they are similar.
No. But they are not touching each other.
Beech mein kabhi na touch mein.
TAB is yes, 2 root AB, and TBC is yes, 2 root BC, but TAC will be what? That will be root of D square minus A minus C square. And what is D? D is distance between their centers. Tell me what is this distance?
A plus 2B plus C.
A plus B plus B plus C. So this will be. So let me write simply TAC square, okay? So that is A plus C plus 2B whole square minus A minus C whole square, correct? So what is this? This is nothing but A square plus C square plus 4B square plus 2AC plus 4AB plus 4BC minus A square plus C square minus
2AC.
So can I remove?
Yes.
So plus this will 2AC. Be 2AC. So this will get cancelled. So I am left with, see, this plus this will become 4. So 4 into bracket B square plus
AC plus
AB plus BC plus AC. Correct? So this is TAC whole square. And we know that TAC whole square is nothing but TAB plus TBC whole square. That is 2 times root AB plus root BC whole square. Correct? size and their size don't match, so don't do it.
Is it a mouse?
Tiny alien creature, he won't be able to do anything to you unless you scare me. So that will be 4 times this square, correct? So what I will equate these two. First I'll cancel 4, so I'll get b square plus ab plus bc plus ac is nothing but ab plus bc plus 2 root. Now a b square c, right? Okay, so ab and bc will get cancelled. So you have, yes, this will be what? B square plus ac and minus, I'll shift it here. I can get 2b outside root ac. This is nothing but b minus
root ac the whole square.
Root ac the whole square is equal to 0. So b is equal to root ac, or b square is ac. So we say that b is joining mean of a and c. Okay? Easy. I mean, there was a little calculation, and the first problem is done.
Yes.
It was easy.
Can I clear this part?
Yes.
So now, instead of 3 circles, if I have 5,
and suppose, assume that my figure is nice and they are, okay, of course they feel wrong.
If you can just assume there are 5.
Yeah, suppose there are angles and circles, 2 angles to each other.
Okay. Okay, this is not a puzzle. This is fine. Okay, okay. So this problem, is it okay? I'll solve next time.
Yes.
I'll do the puzzle. Equilateral triangle with same.
We should prove that some point.
Yes. Okay. So last time I had given some puzzle about. So those who are not there, I'll just remind them that we can prove that if all points in a plane are colored with either red or blue, then we can get a segment whose all endpoints, whose endpoints and the midpoints are of same color. Correct? We have proved this. Huh? Okay? That can be easily proved. Okay? What you do is, you just take 3 points PQR and extend it so that suppose this distance is x, then this distance is x and here this distance is x. So S and T, and then you do combinations of coloring, you will get that. There exists at least one segment whose end points and middle point are of the same. Now again we have colored the plane with two colors, red and blue, and we wish to prove that there exists an equilateral triangle of same color, monochromatic equilateral. What I will do is, I will take a segment PQR and its endpoints of same color, BBB, blue blue blue. Now let me create equilateral triangles here. Okay? And extend this. Okay? So suppose this is S, T, and M. Now, can I clear this? Can I clear this calculation? Nobody is copying it. Everybody got it? Well, now. Suppose M is blue, then I'll get triangle MPR. Suppose S is blue, SPQ. Suppose T is blue,
PQR.
These are blue triangles. But none of them is blue. Suppose M, S and T are all red, then we get a red triangle. So in any case we get one equilateral triangle whose all three vertices are of same color. Everybody understood the problem? Should I repeat? BC students?
Yes ma'am.
Huh? Is there anybody who has not followed? Should I repeat this?
Yes,
yes. See, the question was like this, that I have colored entire plane with either red or blue. I need to prove that there exists equilateral triangle whose all three vertices are of same color. Okay? So what I did is, I took a segment with endpoints and midpoint of same color. Okay? Say blue, and create an equilateral triangles like this, so that this is a medial triangle of this triangle. Okay? And now if M is blue, then I get MPR blue, S is blue, I get SPQ blue, or T is blue, then I get TQR blue. So if any one of this is blue, I get a blue triangle. And if none of them is blue, then I'll get a red.
Miss, how do you know they can't get a combination of blue and red?
Even if one of them is blue, suppose M is blue and these two are red, still I'll get MPR.
Correct?
They can be either blue or red. Okay? Follow? Okay, now next puzzle. This is one of my favorite. You just have to hear it out and then try it. So I have a spear. Have a spear.
I'll give you another. 12% of the sphere is colored black and the rest of the sphere is white.
How? A cube or something inside that ball.
Yes. We have to prove that there exists a rectangular box that can be kept inside the sphere so that all its vertices are touching the white portion of the sphere. Problem is, we don't know how the black portion is covered. No. Sorry, 12.5 inch never work. Honey, try it. Okay? So for those who already know this puzzle, another puzzle. Greater than 5.
See, you put some 6 points here. This is length 3, this is length 4. You are dividing into unit squares, 12 unit squares. You are placing 6 points in this.
So 1 point per unit square.
Anywhere.
Achha.
Not even 1 point per unit square. You have 12 squares and 6 points.
So means on the vertex.
Anywhere.
Achha.
Inside this. Okay?
So we have to prove that
at least one pair of points will be there such that
in any way we do it.
Any way you do. Okay?
So we can just prove that we do one or something.
You have to prove it in general, no?
But sir, can we go diagonally? Or we have to go
anyway, whatever you see, placing points is not your choice. Try to understand. I will place the points. You have to prove it. Means you can't take nice distances and prove it. You have to prove it for any choice of placement. So assume worst case and prove it. Okay?
Ma'am?
Yes, beta?
Ma'am, I have one doubt in trigonometry.
Yes.
Ma'am, whenever we find a series for a tan, then like we find tan 2a, it's like 2 tan a upon 1 minus tan square a. Tan 3a is 3 tan a minus tan cube upon 1 minus 3 tan square a. So why do we always get binomial coefficients only?
Sorry?
Why do we always get binomial coefficients only?
On A. Achha. Okay. What is your question? Can you repeat? Tan 2A.
Tan. 2 tan A upon 1 minus tan square A.
2 tan A upon 1 minus tan square A. Correct. And 3A is?
And ma'am, 3 tan A minus tan cube upon 1 minus 3 tan square A.
1 minus 3. See, basically, there is a general formula for this beta. Okay?
Thank you.
down. Very good.